Welcome on this Friday evening as we gather to enjoy evening prayer. Just bear with me while I change something on the sound. That will reduce the amount of echo, I think. All right. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Peace to those who are far off. Peace to those who are near. Glory to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. He was despised. He was rejected. A man of sorrows, acquainted with grief. As one from whom people hide their faces, he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Ours were the sufferings he bore, ours the torments he endured. While we thought he was being punished, struck by God and brought low, he was pierced for our sins, bruised for no fault but ours. His punishment has won our peace, and by his wounds we are healed. We had all strayed like sheep, all taking our own way, but the Lord laid on him the guilt of us all. The day is now past, the night is at hand. Let us pray with one heart and mind. We pause in the time of silence to gather our thoughts before God. Father of lights, receive the prayer and praise we offer you as our evening sacrifice. Make us a light for all the world, delivered by your goodness from all the works of darkness, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Our psalm for this evening is Psalm 81. We'll say it by alternate verses. O sing joyfully to God our strength, shout in triumph to the God of Jacob. Make music and beat upon the drum, sound the lute and the melodious harp. Blow the ram's horn at the new moon and at the full moon of our day of festival. For it is a statute for Israel. A commandment of the God of Jacob, which he laid on Joseph as a solemn charge when he came out of the land of Egypt.
I heard a voice that I had not known, saying, I eased your shoulders of the burden, and your hands were free from the load.
You called me in trouble, and I rescued you. I answered you from the secret places of my thunder. I put you to the test at the waters of Meribah. Listen, my people, and I will admonish you. O Israel, if only you would hear me. There shall be no strange god among you, nor shall you bow down to an alien god. I am the Lord your God, who brought you up from the land of Egypt. Open wide your mouth, and I will fill it. But my people would not listen to my voice, and Israel would have none of me. So I left them in the stubbornness of their hearts to walk according to their own designs. If only my people would listen, if Israel would but walk in my ways, I would soon put down their enemies and turn my hand against their adversaries. Those that hate the Lord would cringe before him, and their punishment would last forever.
But Israel, I would feed with the finest wheat and satisfy you with the honey from the rocks.
Holy Spirit, sanctify, cleanse us from all hypocrisy, unite us to one another in the bonds of peace and love, and confirm us in holiness through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The first of our readings this evening is from Isaiah chapter 42, verses 1 to 17. It's one of the servant songs. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry or lift up his voice or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not grow faint or be crushed until he has established justice in the earth, and the coastlands wait for his teaching. Thus says God, the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes from it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have given you a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison, those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory I give to no other, nor my praise to idols. See, the former things have come to pass, and new things I now declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them. Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise from the end of the earth. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the coastlands and their inhabitants. Let the desert and its towns lift up their voice, the villages that Kedar inhabits. Let the inhabitants of Selah sing for joy. Let them shout from the tops of the mountains. Let them give glory to the Lord and declare his praises in the coastlands. The Lord goes forth like a soldier, like a warrior. He stirs up his fury. He cries out, he shouts aloud. He shows himself mighty against his foes. For a long time I have held my peace. I have kept still and restrained myself. Now I will cry out like a woman in labor. I will gasp and pant. I will lay waste mountains and hills and dry up all their herbage. I will turn the rivers into islands and dry up the pools. I will lead the blind by a road they do not know, by paths they have not known, I will guide them. I will turn the darkness before them into light, the rough places into level ground. These are the things I will do, and I will not forsake them. They shall be turned back and utterly put to shame, those that trust in carved images, who say to cast images, "You are our gods." Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
John's going to read for us now from 1 Thessalonians.
As Mike said, the second reading is the first epistle of St. Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 4, commencing at verse 1. Finally, brothers and sisters, I ask and urge you in the Lord Jesus that as you learn from us how you ought to live and to please God, as in fact you are doing, you should do so more and more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. For this is the will of God, your sanctification, that you abstain from fornication, that each of you knows how to control your own body in holiness and honor, not with lustful passion like the Gentiles who do not know God. That no one wrongs or exploits a brother or sister in this matter, because the Lord is an avenger in all these things, just as we have already told you beforehand and solemnly warned you. For God did not call us to impurity, but in holiness. Therefore, whoever rejects this rejects not human authority, but God, who also gives his Holy Spirit to you. Now concerning love of the brothers and sisters, you do not need to have anyone write to you, for you yourselves have been taught by God to love one another. And indeed you do love all the brothers and sisters throughout Macedonia. But we urge you, beloved, to do so more and more, to aspire to live quietly, to mind your own affairs, and to work with your hands as we directed you, so that you may behave properly towards outsiders and be dependent on no one. May your word live in us and bear much fruit to your glory.
Second of our canticles is the Song to the Lamb. You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honour and power. For you have created all things, and by your will they have their being. You are worthy, O Lamb, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransom for God saints from every tribe and language and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests, serving our God, and they shall reign with you on earth. To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing and honour and glory and might for ever and ever. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The collect for the week following the first Sunday of Advent. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put on the armour of light, now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came among us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty, to judge the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. In our intercessions, as we share in the cycle of prayer across the Anglican Communion, we pray this night, Father, for the Diocese of Shinyanga in Tanzania. Their Bishop Johnson Chimyongol, for your clergy and people as they serve you in that part of Tanzania. We ask your wisdom and guidance on them as they seek to be a people of truth and integrity in the life of that country. We pray too for the Episcopal Church of Eau Claire, William J. Lambert, their Bishop, for the clergy and people of that diocese. In Australia, we pray this night for the Diocese of Bathurst, Mark Calder, their bishop, for the clergy and people, that you would help them with your wisdom and grace, especially in the season as they reach out into the community in various ways to bring the message of Christ into a secular world. We pray for the parish of Mount Cravat, Gary Smith, as he comes to complete a locum there, and as they look to the arrival of their new parish priest, for the retired clergy, Cheryl Selvage, Colin Roberts, Trevor Butler, Claire Johnson, for your people as they serve you on the south side of Brisbane. We uphold to you the work of Anglicare and Karen Crouch and her staff in their important role of coordinating and overseeing the work of Anglicare in southern Queensland. In our schools, we pray for Canterbury College at Waterford, Daniel Walker, their principal, Naya Vivani, their chaplain, Jeff Thomas, the chair of College Council, the members of the College Council, the staff and the students, especially in this time of holidays. Be with families, we pray, for their refreshment and strengthening. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And this night we pray for all those who live their lives in the midst of a disability. We're mindful, Father, that if we go out to shopping centres or anywhere, it's not hard to see people who live their lives with limitations, with restrictions on their movements, who deal with pain and discomfort each day. We uphold to you these people. We are mindful of the work of the NDIS in seeking to bring programs and resources available to those with disabilities. We pray for the progression and effectiveness of that program, and help us as your people to be aware and responsive to the needs of people with disabilities in our community, and help us to understand ways in which we can be of help and support. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We also pray, Father, for the elderly with the diversity of needs that they have. We especially pray for those who withdraw into their homes, who don't connect out into the community. Help us as a faith community to provide opportunities for them to come out and to enjoy interaction with others. Help us in the way we use the resources of technology and even good old a knock on the door and taking time for a cuppa and a chat to help our elderly day by day. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And as we come to a Friday, we are mindful of those who are looking for a time of relaxation and refreshment. We pray for those who will travel on our roads, that all may arrive safely at their destination. We pray too, Father, for rain in this hot and humid weather, with the promise and the hope of rain. We pray that there will indeed be a lowering of pressure systems in the north that would enable rains to come. And we pray your help and provision for the rains that will make transformation not only of the land but in people's lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray together the evening collect. Lighten our darkness, Lord, we pray, and in your great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night for the love of your only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us praise the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the God of all grace, who has called us to eternal glory in Christ, restore, establish, strengthen us. To him be the dominion for ever and ever. Amen. That brings us to the close of our service this evening. Thank you again for being with us, and I invite you to join us on Sunday morning as we come to the second Sunday of Advent, and this week we light the candle of peace, something that is much longed for, and we'll come to understand and explore what that peace means in the world today. So we bid you good night and God bless, and look forward to joining with you again on Sunday or next week.